worthy to be exalted. Come and lift up your voice and worship this King of Kings, this Lord of Lords, the Alpha and Omega, our Maker, our Helper, our Deliverer. Let's give him praise. Let's open our mouth and give him praise. Let's thank God for helping us even to come together this evening. Father, we thank you for today's activities. Some of us, you went to work, you came back safely. Some of them, you went for one activity or the other, and you are here this evening. Go ahead and give him praise. Don't take it for granted. Don't take it for granted. Let's appreciate and worship him. Give him praise. Adore him. Father, we bless you, Lord. Father, we give you praise, Lord. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. I want you to lift up your voice and say, Father, speak to me this evening, Lord. I'm ready to receive from you. Speak to me, minister to my needs, oh God. In the name of Jesus, I don't want to be a spectator. Father, please, I want you to visit me in the unusual way this evening. Father, please visit me. Meet me at the very point of my needs this evening, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Are you opening your mouth? Why can't you open your mouth and pray to God this evening? Lord, please visit me, Lord. Thank you, faithful Father. Lord, we give all the glory. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. So, Heavenly Father, we want to thank you. We want to thank you for the opportunity even to come at your feet once again. Father, be glorified in Jesus' name. Thank you for how you have helped us thus far this day. We bless your name for our going out and our coming in. Father, we return all the glory, Daddy, in Jesus' name. Father, as we go to your word this evening, Holy Spirit, interpret your word to us in Jesus' name. Let every life here be blessed in the name of Jesus. By the time we are finishing this teaching, let your name be glorified. Thank you, faithful Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Come on, welcome to at least 30 people to church. Welcome your neighbor to your left, to your right. Say you're welcome to church. God bless you. Good to see you. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. Come, please have your seat. Hallelujah. Praise God. Good to see your face this evening. It's a good thing to be in the God's presence. The Bible says in his presence there is fullness of joy. It's my belief this evening the Lord is going to visit somebody in the name of Jesus. I want to thank God for the privilege given us to share the word of God. I want to appreciate the pastorate. Particularly our pastor and the Lord Pastor Sheikh of Olavi for giving me this privilege. We are continuing in the topic we started last week. Who can remind us of the topic we started last week? How many of us were around last week? Yes. Steps to greatness. Hallelujah. Steps to greatness. And I believe we learned a lot of things. Our daddy actually took the teaching and he mentioned a lot of things. But for those of us that were not around, I'm just going to take a few minutes to actually brush through some of the things he said. We started with the word steps to greatness. And we need to let us know that it's the mandate of God for you, for me, to be great. God has greatness. God has called us into greatness. We need to understand it. We need to have it at the back of our mind that it is the desire of God for you and I to be great. So we need to understand that concept that it is the desire of God. Come on, say it to yourself. It is the desire of God for my life to be great. So we need to understand that. Because God's desire for you and I is to be great. How do you know? Because he said this. He said you are going to be the head and not the tail. He said you shall be above and not beneath. So as a Christian, we are called to greatness. We are to fly. Mandate of
concerning our life. This mic is breaking. It is the mandate of God concerning our life for us to live a life of greatness. We understand that greatness is God's will for our lives. According to 3 John verse 2, say, I wish you above all things that it be and be in health and prosper, even as thy soul prospereth. So it is the desire of God for you, for you and I, to prosper, to be great. And Jeremiah chapter 29 verse 11 said, God said, the thought I have towards you are of good and not of what? And not of evil. So it is the mandate of God for you and I to be great. We need to have that concept stabilized in our spirit, that it is the mandate of God. And our daddy made us to understand one of the steps to actually attain greatness, and he talks about separation. Come on, say separation. For you to be great, you are separated. The Bible makes us to understand the book of Genesis chapter 12 verse 1 to 3, when God called Abraham. The Bible said, God said unto Abraham, Genesis chapter 12 verse 1 to 3, God said unto Abraham, he said, get thee out of thy father's house, get thee out of thy country, get thee out of thy kindred, and go to a place that I will send thee. He said, and I will make thee a great nation. He said, thee, all the earth will be blessed. So one of the mandate of God concerning me, for us to be blessed, for us to be graced, we must be called to separation. You must live a life of separations. What are we saying? If God can call Abraham separation, God require you to live a life of separation. The Bible makes us understand the book of Galatians chapter 3 verse 29. It said, anybody that is in Christ, we are Abraham's seed. Anybody that is in Christ, we are what? Abraham's seed. Meaning the promises upon Abraham is actually working in our lives. All the promises, they are working in our lives. So if you are Abraham's seed, you have the mandate of greatness upon you. If you are Abraham's seed, you have the mandate of greatness. You have the mandate of blessing upon your life. So if the first thing God asks Abraham to do is what? Is to be separated. And the desire of God for us to be separated too. What are the areas we need to be separated from? We need to separate ourselves from the world. The Bible calls to understand the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 6 verse 14. It said we should be unequally yoked with unbelievers. So we need to be separated from the world if you want to be great. Somebody say, if you flow with the crowd, you will be lost in the crowd. So if you want to flow with the world, you will be lost in the world. So the only way to be enter the place of greatness as Christian, you must be ready to what? You ready to live a life of separation. Come on, say separation. God requires we separate from the world. We should separate from evil doings. We should separate from evil associations. The Bible makes us to understand the book of Ephesians chapter 5 verse 11. We should say we should not have anything to do with darkness. 2 Thessalonians chapter 3 verse 3. He said, mark those people, those brothers, you know, that live disorderly. That's what the scripture says. So, as a Christian, you want to be great. Number one thing, we need to understand that you need to be separated. Tell your neighbor you need to be separated. So, you want to be great. Number one requirement is for you to be separated. So, to continue this evening, we want to go a little bit further and talking about step to greatness part 2. And to start, what does it mean to be great? What does it mean to be great? I put it here, to be great is to be understanding what you do. To be great is to understand whatever one does. It means to be successful. It means to be prosperous. To be outstanding in whatever calling God has called you. Oh, Oh, you're a medical doctor. It is the mandate of God for your life to be a medical doctor with difference. Oh, you are a teacher. It is the mandate of God for you to live a life of greatness in that capacity God has called you. Oh, you are a police officer. God wants you to be different. God wants you to be great, that you become a point of reference. So it is the mandate of God for you and I to be great. We need to have that understanding. And what does it mean to be great? Is what? Is to be outstanding. So this evening we'll be majoring, major point of discussion will be law that governs greatness. What did I say? In this kingdom we are in, it is operated by laws. It is operated by principles. Somebody said principles are made from principles. If you want to become a principal in any of your endeavor, you must be governed by principles. You see, a man that is not governed by principles, he will live a meaningless life. So if you want to be great, you must be governed by principles. And that is why we are talking about secrets and the step to greatness. So there are steps, because secret is what makes a man to be outstanding. Secret is what is the key to success. So I want to start by saying, greatness is not a promise, it is a covenant. What did I say? Greatness is not a promise, what? It is a covenant. And covenants are guided by principle. How do I know? Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 1. Deuteronomy 28, verse 1. He said, if you will obey. He said, if you obey and hearken to my word. He said, I will make you to be above and not beneath. Meaning, for you to be great, you have a mandate to fulfill. And the mandate, number one mandate, you must be ready to be hearken to the principles of the kingdom. He said, it shall come to pass if thou shalt hearken, did let thee ready to the voice of the law and observe to do all his commandments, which I commanded this day, the Lord thy God will say the what? So for you to be great, you must what? Walk by the principles of obedience. You need to do your part. Tell your neighbor, do your part. So number one principles of greatness is you have to improve yourself daily. Come and say, improve yourself daily. You need to improve yourself daily. You want to live a life of greatness as Christian, we need to improve ourselves. Sir, you are not called into Christianity to conform with the world, but to transform the world. And I repeat myself. You are not called to conform with the world. We are called to transform the world. So we have to be, we be ready to improve ourselves. And what are the areas we need to improve ourselves? Philippians chapter 3 verse 13. Let's start from there. Philippians chapter 3 verse 13. We need to improve ourselves. This is Apostle Paul talking. He said, I can't know myself to have apprehended, but one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind me, reaching forth unto those things which are before me. If you must reach a height of greatness, Sama, you must improve yourself. You cannot be doing things over and over and expect different results. Not in an ordinary way and express extraordinary results. So if you must experience extraordinary results, you must put in extraordinary efforts. So you must improve yourself. How do you, in what area you must improve your quality of life as a Christian? Number one way of improving, you have to improve your spiritual life. You need to improve your spiritual life. Smith Wigglesworth, if you remain at the same position consecutively for 2 days in your Christian race, you are backslidden. So if you need to be great, you want to keep on improving yourselves. the same lifestyle of your spirituality you used to do 3 years ago, 4 years ago. You are the same. That 5 minute prayer, sharper, sharper. From the bedroom, you start your praise and worship from the bedroom. What are they, you know, and you finish everything, pray, you run out. Is that how to live a life and you want to be great? A people that must be great must have a quality relationship with God. Am I talking to someone here? So if you have to, you have to improve your spiritual life. You have to improve your spiritual life. How often do you read the word of God? Sir, it is what you know that gives you an edge. And that is why it is called knowledge. It is what you know that gives you an edge over somebody that does not know. And that is what God, knowledge. If you check the word knowledge, is know an edge. It is the understanding you have that makes you an outstanding in life. So if you lack knowledge about a particular thing in your life, you cannot have an edge over somebody that does not know. You want to be great, you must acquire knowledge. Hosea chapter 4 verse 6 said, my people perish because of what? Lack of knowledge. So if you don't know something spiritually, you are about to be molested by the devil. So if you want to be great, you must what? Improve yourself. You must improve yourself according what? The word of the Lord. You must read your word of God every day. You must improve yourself. You have been reading like 30 verses in a day. You have to improve. You have to improve. I used to have a provincial pastor. He challenged me. He said, there is no day, no matter how busy he will be, that at least he must read at least a chapter from books. He must read the book. He must at least read even on a page. He must read something. The books. How many of the Christians today are reading books? How many of us are investing in books? And that is why we have a lot of mediocrity concerning Christendoms. Because most of all, we don't give ourselves to learning. That is why it is easy for us to actually reign. David Oyedepo said before he established a university, he has to study about 250 biographies of all that university. No wonder it's raining in that realm. Sir, ma, if you want to have an edge over somebody else, you must know more than that person. In your business, you want to reign, sir, you must know what the other person does not know. Hello? You want people to patronize you? You must improve yourself. You cannot keep on doing it the way it used to be. Come and tell your neighbor, improve yourself. So, if I have to be great, I need to improve myself. You need to improve yourself spiritually. Don't let me dwell much about that because we all know what it is. You need to improve yourself academically. You need to improve yourself academically. I understand. They say, after all, this Nigeria, everything. But keep on improving yourself. Keep on improving yourself. Improve yourself concerning your career. Improve yourself in your interpersonal relationship. Improve yourself. Some of us, we think just patch into people and think they will just come around and do something. But somebody you don't talk with, somebody you don't relate, and you just patch into him, say he must do something for you. It doesn't happen that way. You must improve yourself. So you have to improve yourself. You know why they keep the Oyibos, the manufacturers of cars, they used to collect money from us. Because they keep on improving on the model. They will tell us 2020 model, 2021 model. And now one thing they go change, maybe not lights. They will change the light, maybe the front light, and they say 2022 model. And we will pay for it. So if you have to be paid more, you need to improve yourself. Am I talking to someone? Proverbs 22 verse 29. Proverbs 22 verse 29. It says, seeth a man diligent in his work, he shall stand before king and not what? diligent. Be diligent. Improve. 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 As a choir, improve in that capacity. Improve. Improve. Amen. Number two, principles of greatness. Never neglect an opportunity. Come on, say, never neglect an opportunity. Opportunity will always come. The opportunity we only ask for those people that are prepared. You want to be great? Never neglect an opportunity. Genesis chapter 41 verse 14. Genesis chapter 41 verse 14. Bible speaking about concerning Joseph. When they called himself Pharaoh's son and called Joseph, and they brought him what? Hastily out of the dungeon. He saved himself. Charged his raiment. It came out. He didn't say, because I'm coming from the prison. He just bad into the palace like that. So he, because when they say king needed to, he has to preserve himself where? Sama. As worker, they give you 5 minutes to lead prayer and worship. They lead you. You miss most of the opportunities because you fail. And that's, you never get that platform again. Oh, they give you a job. You are a fashion designer. You spoil everything. And you say God is not answering. It is you that what? Miss the opportunity. Bakari said something. Pastor Bakari, Tunde Bakari, he said, well, the guy was actually showing his agbada. He says, Abeokuta Oso, a Muslim guy. He said, the guy is actually showing for almost of the senators. He said, they have to send the materials through flights to Abeokuta, and they have to, Ejo, from Abuja, they have to carry Gilarelo Agbada. Small opportunity they give you, please use it well, because you may never get it again. On Sunday, the provincial youth president was like saying, they have given a lot of platform for the youths in the province, but most of them mess them up. They gave you a job in Unilever, you will invest $165 million or so. Sir, okay, there are some of us for touch. Nobody say you are hitting from the altar, you are hitting the altar. No, it is an opportunity. You don't think that people are taking note of all those things. And when the time of opportunity comes, they know to present. They put you in a department. They say, Oga, help us handle this money. After some time, they cannot trace the money with you. Money missed on transit. Never neglect. 2 Chronicles 27 verse 6. 2 Chronicles 27 verse 6. He said, Dothan became mighty. Because what? Sir, prepare, prepare. Prepare, 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 prepare. Prepare. Ah, can I talk to the youth? Oh, some of us, we want a lot. I want a very husband that is this, that is not fearing, that is this, that is that, that is that. The question is that, are you fit? God will be unfair to give a good brother to what? Abba. And as a brother, I need a sister who's branded, fire brand, kaka speaking, tongues, lipal, lekete, media, lada. And then you as a brother to pray for 10 minutes. You think God is unfair? Abba. So you want to be great? Come and say, you'll never prepare yourself. Number three, principle of greatness. Commit yourself to a worthy goal. Commit yourself to a what? A worthy goal. Philippians chapter 1 verse 23. The Apostle Paul said, my goal is to glorify God. Have a goal. Have a vision. You are pursuing. Commit yourself. I have a desire. Somebody said your aim in life determines your end in life. Your aim determines your what? Your end. If you cannot aim it, you can never have it. What you cannot picture, you cannot feature. What you cannot see, you cannot cease. What is your vision? If I ask you what is your vision for the next 5 years, what will you tell me? What do you intend doing for the next 1 year? What do you intend doing? What is your vision? When you live a visionless life, you live a disorganized life. So you must commit yourself to a goal. You must have a vision. You must have a vision of what you want to become in life. You must tell yourself. You must have a vision. Tell your neighbor, have a vision. Number four. I said number one, improve yourself daily. If you want to be great, you have to improve yourself daily. Number two, never neglect an opportunity. Any opportunity given to you, maximize that opportunity. You may not get that opportunity again. Maximize it. And number three, I said commit yourself up to a worthy goal. You must have something you want to achieve. I want to become this. This is my desire. This is what I want to achieve. You want to be great. Have a goal, a target. Have a target. I have never seen somebody having a first class in school by mistake. They must be committed to it. So you want to be great? You have to be committed to it. Number four. Run with your vision. Come and say, run with your vision. It is another thing to have a vision. It's another thing to what? Run with it. Because there's no difference between somebody that has a vision that cannot run with it and the person that does not have vision at all. So, you need to have a vision and you must be ready to run with that vision. You must be ready to run with the vision. Proverbs 29 verse 18. Proverbs 29 verse 18. You must be ready to run with the vision. Say, where there is no vision, the people perish. So, if there is no vision, people must what? Perish. Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 2 to 3. Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 2 to 3. Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 2 to 3. He said, write the vision down. He said, Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 2 to 3. He said, what? Write the vision down. He said, the Lord answered me and said, write the vision, make it plain upon the tables that it may run. Write the vision down. You have a vision? Write it down. Write it down. Write it down. Write it down. Put it down. This is what I want to achieve. Put it down. I want to be great. I want to be this. Put it down. Run with that vision. Number five, encourage and employ others to buy into your vision. Encourage and employ others to buy what? Sir, you cannot do it alone. Are we together? Jesus could not do it alone. He needed the what? The disciples to help him. That is why the Bible says in the book of Mark, Mark chapter 3, verse 13, downward, he said, he called the 12 unto himself and he gave them. You have a vision. You know, Jesus was so explicit here. He called them and he led those people that he wanted to help him to know his vision. So, if you want to be great, you need the help of others. When I hear people say, I don't need the help of people. I don't need the help of people. I only need God. Sir, God will not come down from heaven to help you. You need people to actually fulfill the mandate. So that is why you must make your vision known. You must have a solid one that can actually, you can convince people to actually help you to achieve. So you need to encourage, employ others to buy into your vision. You cannot do it alone. If you try it, he said, and he on day 12, that they should what? Be with him. That's the number one reason. That he might send forth to them what? To preach. So he called them. He needed them. Six. You need to accept responsibility for your life. You need what? Responsibility only answer to great people. When great people are men of what? Of responsibility. Stop giving excuses. I lost my father when I was 10 years old. I did this, sir. There are some people, maybe you lost your father at the age of 10. There are some people that they lost their father before they came to the world. Stop giving excuses. I understand Nigeria system, but stop Buhari. Take responsibility for your life. Take responsibility. You want to be great? You must accept responsibility for your life. In the book of Genesis chapter 3 verse 11 to 12. Genesis chapter 3 verse 11 to 12. When they beheld Adam eat the forbidden fruit, the first thing when God asked, called upon Adam, the first thing he gave excuses. He said it was the woman. It was the woman. We wouldn't have been having a problem in choice of marriage today. Assuming Adam took responsibility. Because as a man, God will just appear and say, guy, talk early Yahweh, and that will be the best for you. But after the excuses, God has said, I made a mistake for making you what? Giving you a wife. And that's why from that day he said, ask, it shall be given to you. So, stop giving excuses. Tell your neighbor, stop giving excuses. You need to accept responsibility. Number seven. Select your friends. You want to be great? You deliberate concerning this. You need to select your friends. Select your friends. James chapter 4, verse 4. James chapter 4, verse 4. He said, the friend to the world is an enmity to go what? To God. Select your friends. He said, ye adulterers, adulteresses, know ye not that the friendship of the world is what? Enmity. Sir, if most of your friends are worldly people, there is nothing you can tell anybody you are worldly. Select your friend. You cannot be moving with mediocres and expect to be outstanding. Select your friends. You want to be great? Select the kinds of friends you want to be moving with. Select your friends. You need to be deliberate concerning this. Because a lot of people are missing in life because of wrong friends. Because of wrong associations. Select your friends. Friends that you will move with. A lot of marriages are in crisis today because of what? Bad influence of friends. Select your friends. Come and tell your neighbor, select your friends. Sir, ma, God mandated us to love everyone. To love everyone. But it is not the mandate that everyone must be your friend. Am I talking to you? I love you. I love you. I love everyone. But everyone here is not my friend. That's the truth of the matter. You need to be deliberate. Select your friend. You need to look at the group of your friends. How many of them you have to actually talk? Shun. Name them. Kini tope shenu ayemi. Shun. Kino maso. You know there are some friends. If you tell them, say this is your vision, they will crash down the vision. I say, I want to do business. And business you go. Ori, mommy wale to she, nothing. They will crash down your vision. As on friends like that. You ask yourself, ask yourself. Select your friends. And another point, number eight. Envelope yourself in the atmosphere of the Holy Spirit. Envelope yourself in the atmosphere of the Holy Spirit, if you have to be great, you must envelope yourself in the atmosphere what of the Holy Spirit, because you cannot do it by your own power. He said, by strength shall no man prevail. Sir, ma, if you do it with your own power, you will fail. You need God's strength. That is why you need to align yourself with God. Galatians chapter 5 verse 25. He said, if you are in the spirit, you must walk in the spirit. So you need to be in the atmosphere of the spirit for you to fulfill what? Greatness. And that is why we encourage people, it is easier to fulfill when you are in the atmosphere of God's presence. It is easier for you to actually fulfill the mandate of God. James chapter 4 verse 8. James 4, 8. God said, draw near to me and I will draw near. So it's a matter of do your own, I will do my own. Jude chapter 1 verse 20. Jude chapter 1 verse 20. He said, brethren, beloved, he said, let us build up ourselves. Build. You want to be great? You must be ready to what? Build up yourself. And after you are building yourself, you must be ready to be a man of God, of the Holy Ghost. Hello? Sir, ma, for you to be great. If it is either you are in a secret court or you are in a secret place. Hello? If you must be great, it is either you are in the secret court or if you don't belong to anyone, I see you are new. I've told you a story of two people. They are people that are contending for a contract in a place. And the other girl one got a kind of a, he got a big bottle. A bottle, you know, in that bottle, there is a, he put, I don't know, you know, this occulting power. There's a live snake in that bottle. Every time he goes for any bidding concerning contract, he will drink water from that snake in the bottle. So, and you want to go and contend with such a person? 5 minute prayer. You know the kind of prayer. But you sometimes some of us thank God, say, okay, God, you understand. I must not be late. You understand. And you get to that guy, and the guy is talking, and you say, I hear you got that delay. Imagine. And this guy, and I know God. And God will say, it's not be my fault. So it is either you become what? You belong to secret court, or what? You belong to secret place. And where is the secret place? God. They that dwell in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under what? Psalm 91 verse 1. We want to be great, we must be governed by principles. Because principles are made by principles. If you don't have principles that your lifestyle, then you are not ready to be great. Last week we talked about separation. You need to be separated. You need to separate yourself from the world. Today, we have just talked about what? Principles of greatness. And number one, you need to improve yourself daily. Never neglect an opportunity. Commit yourself to a worthy goal. Run with your vision. Encourage and employ others to buy into your vision. Accept responsibility for your life. And we said, select your friends. And lastly, we talk about envelope yourself in the atmosphere of the Holy Ghost. Before I ask your question, I want you to bow down your ears. I want you to cry to God. If I ask us how many of us want to be great, every one of us will raise up. I bet how many of us are ready to abide with the principles? Why can't you apply for grace? I need the grace to be diligent. I need the grace to be trustworthy. I need the grace to be faithful in my assignment. I need the grace to prepare myself. I need the grace when I'm supposed to fast. I need the grace to fast. I need the grace to pray when I'm supposed to pray. I need the grace to pray when I'm supposed to pray. Oh God, give me the grace. I need the grace, Lord. I need the grace, Lord. Help me. Help me, Lord. Give me the grace. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. I pray for everyone seated there, the Lord will give you grace. The grace to live by this principle, the Lord will release it upon you. In the mighty name of Jesus. It is my prayer this morning, this evening, you will not fail your generation. You will not fail God. I will not fail my generation. I will not fail God. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, we are praying. If you have been blessed, come and jam your hands to God Almighty. Time for your question. Any questions? Contributions? Questions, contributions, suggestions, observations. Paraventure, I've said something I'm not supposed to say. Please call me to order now. It's only in Bible study you can call the preacher or the teacher to order. Sunday, you cannot call anybody to order. But in the teaching like this, you can ask your questions. You can actually correct us. Any questions? Any suggestions? I believe you are really blessed. Once again, come and jam your hands to God as we invite our pastor.
Amen. Shall we rise to pray? Let's pray for our pastor that God has used tonight. That God will continue to bless him. That God will increase his knowledge. Let's pray that the hand of God will continue to be upon his life. He has watered us. Let's pray that God will water him also. That he will also become great, he would also attain greatness. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Father, once again, we thank you for tonight's teaching. We ask, O Lord, that you help us to abide by the principles that will make us great. We ask that you teach us your way. All that we need to do, please give us what it takes to abide by them in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, because you have answered. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. The Lord bless us in Jesus' name. Let's put our hands in our pockets. The choir will help us as we give our offering.